Hey everybody and welcome back to another Darkfall video. So today we're going to be looking at version 1.3 of the Darkfall VFX Nodes. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, there'll be a link up here and you can watch the first video in this series. Or if you want to download the updated version, there'll be a link in the description. Then if you scroll down, you can click this button here, which will take you to the script. So then all we need to do is go over here and just download this. So once this has been downloaded, you just want to make sure you save this to a folder that you'll remember. Then we can go ahead and open up Blender. So now we can replace the old version. Let's go to Edit, then down to Preferences. Then we're going to go down to Add-ons, and then let's search for the add-on. So this is the old version. We can see it's version 1.2. Let's go ahead and remove it. Now we can install from File, and just navigate to the folder where you saved version 1.3. Go ahead and click it and install add-on from file. Now I have this, we can see it's version 1.3. Go ahead and check it to make sure it's active. And then we can go ahead and close this down. Now let's change this window from the 3D view to the compositor. Go ahead and click use nodes, and then we can switch it to the Darkfall VFX nodes panel. So I have been working on a few new things, but it's not really ready yet, so I've decided not to include it in this update. So what I have included, if we go down to Tools, we now have the Film Grain node, so we click this. We have two options. We can first click Color or Black and White, and we can see it adds these two new textures here. So this one here has some color on it, and this one is just black and white, and it's up to you which one you want to use. So let's go ahead and get rid of these nodes here. So this Film Grain node is to add at the end of your compositing, I guess. So let's say we had a scene here already. Let's import a movie clip. Let's go to Output, Composite. In fact, we probably can just go to Artistic, maybe just add in the additional nodes like this. So that's probably easier. Anyway, so now we have these nodes, we can set up a quick basic shot. Let's go ahead and get rid of this image here. Add in a movie clip. Then if we go down here, we can check Backdrop to use the backdrop. So as I say, this Film Grain node is very simple. We just Shift A, go to Color, add in a Mix node, drop this in. So you would add this in after any effects that you did and between any color grading, I guess. Now we have this, let's add in a color film grain node. Then if we plug this into the image, then if we change the blend mode, and depending on which blend mode you choose, you'll get a different effect or a different stylized effect, I guess. So let's go ahead and choose overlay. You're too crazy, so what we'd need to do is bring down the factor. So if we bring this down to say maybe 0.1, let's see how that looks. So we can see very easily we can add in this film grain effect. So with this film grain, we don't really need to do anything. It's already animated. If we jump ahead, we can see it moves around. Let's bring this back up to 1. Then if we jump ahead a frame, we can see it moves. So you can play around with this and get something that fits your shot. But it's a nice, quick, easy way to add film grain to your scene. And again, play around with these blend modes. You'll get something that looks better or different depending on what you're after. Rendering is the same. You just go to render settings, change all these render settings, and then hit render. So this is just another quick and easy effect that we've added to this setup, I guess, to speed up your workflow. If you wanted to add this yourself without these nodes, what we would need to do is change this from the compositor to the texture node editor. Then we'd need to change this to brush, add a new texture, use nodes, and then go ahead and compile the nodes or add the nodes. So if we just change this to the film grain texture, you can see what we've added. So these are the nodes for the film grain texture, we can see. Well, this is for the color. If we had the black and white, we can see it's just one noise texture. It's very simple. We can see the color, it's three noise textures being added together. So there we go. That's it for this week's update. Hopefully you find the film grain node helpful. If you've got any suggestions on how to improve this, or any suggestions that you want to see implemented in the future, go ahead and leave a comment below. As I said, there's some things I wanted to release in this update, but they just weren't ready, and I don't want to release something that's half done. Otherwise, you guys are probably going to get annoyed with that. I mean, I know I'd get annoyed if somebody released a half-finished add-on, so hopefully you guys will appreciate that. So hopefully they will be ready for the next week's update, and hopefully you guys are enjoying this. Be sure to give this video a like. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.